Hi friends, in this video we are studying machine design subject, gears chapter, objective questions and answers. So let's start. In order to test the efficiency of reducer gate train, 1 kilowatt input was given at the input end at a speed of 1440 rpm. At output end, measured torque was 56.36 newton meter. If the ratio of speed reduction in this unit is 10:1, the efficiency is about, we have given 4 options. So here they are telling it is a reducer gate train, 1 kilowatt input is given. So reducer gate train, so 1 kilowatt input is given at the driving gear, or also it can be called as pinion, and then the RPM is 1440. And at output end, the torque measured is 56.36 newton meter. The ratio of speed reduction in this unit is 10:1. So for every 10 revolution of this, there is 1 revolution of this gear. So it is 10:1. So if in case they had given it as 1:10, then the driver is this, driven will be this. So given it is 10:1, so smaller gear has 10 revolution, bigger gear has 1 revolution. Given in this questions are power input 1 kilowatt, so that is 1000 watt, and speed at the small gear is 1440 rpm, and the torque measured at output, see here, torque output end, measured torque was, so torque output is 56.36 newton meter. So speed reduction is 10:1, so that is n input upon n output is equal to 10/1, because input it is 10, output it is 1. So we have already input speed, so we can find the output speed. So input speed is 1440, this is 10/1, so we get output speed. Now power output, so we know power equal to 2 pi nt/60. So we are calculating for the output for this. So 2 pi n t for the output upon 60. So we have n already found, and torque output is given. So we can calculate power output value. Now efficiency is equal to power output upon power input. Like we are giving it 1000 watts of power, and the power output was 849.88 watt. So 1000 watts is supplied and 849.88 was obtained. So that is why it is 849/1000. So that gives 84.9. That is 84.9 is the efficiency. That's nearly equal to 85%. So that concludes option B is correct option. For full depth involutes per gears, minimum number of teeth of pinion to avoid interference depends upon pressure angle, speed ratio, circular pitch, or which diameter. So the question is about full depth involutes per gear with minimum number of teeth, and to avoid interference, it depends upon out of this we have to answer. So let's see what is pressure angle. This is the pressure angle. It is 20 degree and 14.5 degree. And then speed ratio. Speed ratio is N1 by N2 equal to T2 upon T1, where N is speed, T is number of teeth. And then circular pitch. You can see the circular pitch. The distance is called circular pitch. And then pitch diameter. Pitch diameter is diameter of pitch circle. So to avoid interference, the pressure angle should be 20 degree. And speed ratio doesn't affect the interference as well as circular pitch and pitch circle diameter. So therefore option A is correct option. A pair of spur gears with module 5 mm and center distance 40 mm is used for speed reduction of 5:1. The number of teeth on pinion is, so they are asking number of teeth on pinion. So they had given module as 5 mm and center distance 40 mm. Center distance is 40 mm. And then speed reduction is 5:1. So for every 5 revolution of small gear or pinion, there is 1 revolution of big gear. So that is why speed reduction is 5:1. So that we can write N input upon N output, that is pinion. Input is at pinion, output is at this big gear. So NP upon NA equal to TA upon TP, that's equal to 5 divided by 1. That is, we know speed ratio N1 by N2 equal to T2 by T1. We call this as speed ratio. So that is written here. So that is equal to speed reduction 5 upon 1. Now center distance. C equal to R plus R, that is radius of big gear, capital R plus small gear, that is small r. So C equal to R plus R, and C equal to M into TA plus TP by 2. So we know D equal to M into number of teeth. So for radius, R equal to M into number of teeth divided by 2, because diameter by 2 is radius, therefore MT by 2. So we write C equal to M into TA plus TP by 2. So C is given already, that is 40, M is 5, and TA plus TP by 2. So we can write AT equal to TA plus TP. This is number 2, equation number 2. So we have in equation number 1, TA upon TP equal to 5 by 1. So that we can write TA equal to 5 TP. So from this we can write TA is equal to 5 times TP. So that is here. So TA replaced by 5 TP. So that gives TP is equal to 13.3. Number of teeth on pinion equal to 13.3. So that is 13, because 0.3 is less than 0.5, so we consider it as 13. Therefore given option is of value 13.